Coming down to the studio is Middle East expert Yoram Ettinger. Thanks for joining us, Yoram.
Thank you.
Well, you just heard Mark Rekev, and will the course of action that the government's planning now make a difference?
Well, it will make a difference if the government will shift gears from defense to offense. When you defend, you simply invite the enemies to score more and more points against you. It's time for the government to stop focusing on defending the people, but rather or instead attacking the terrorists. Moreover, it's time to shift gears from the symptoms, namely the individual or group terrorist, into the cause. The cause happens to be the ideology behind it, which is nourished, indoctrinated day after day in Mahmoud Abbas' school system from K through 12, mosques and state-controlled media. There's no point of chasing the individual mosquitoes. It's time to drain the educational swamp of the Palestinian Authority.
Now, Mark Rekev has mentioned specifically the incitement going on. They want to attack that offensively, but what would you do besides going after calling for the end of incitement? What else could be done?
Well, not calling. As I said, it's time to attack. The two terrorists came from a very particular neighborhood known to be extremely violent, both militarily as well as ideologically. It's time to clean that swamp. And you clean that swamp by imposing a curfew, and the curfew should last as long as the place is clear of all lethal elements. The same thing should be done in every single location which is suspect and proven to be a source of terrorism. But mostly, also, it calls for enhanced U.S.-Israel cooperation in draining the educational swamp. The U.S. funds the Palestinian Authority to the tune of $400 million every single year, which bankrolls incitement, bankrolls hate education against Jews, against the U.S., against Israel. It's a system which also dooms the Palestinians, majority of whom are not terrorists, to persist living under an oppressive, corrupt terrorist regime. Congress should suspend the funding of that authority. Funding hate education on one hand and American core values on the other hand are oxymoron. Moreover, running educational system which is hate education on one hand and claiming to be partners for peace again is an egregious oxymoron.
Now, Ambassador Ettinger, you know that Israel is under a microscope, and these actions that you mentioned, such as curfew in sections of Jerusalem, do you think the United States, especially Secretary Kerry, understand the situation that Israel existed right now?
Well, this is secondary or tertiary element. The U.S. did not understand Prime Minister Begin when he went ahead and bombed the Iraqi nuclear reactor in 1981. They did not understand us. They punished us with a military embargo. And thank God he did that, because government and people should be ready to pay in the short run in order to advance long-term interests. The danger to the survival of Israel is when a government prefers short-term convenience over long-term conviction.
Well, Ambassador, one more question, very quickly. Secretary Kerry seems to be satisfied with Abbas's statement of condemnation, and yet Israel isn't. What can be done to bridge that sort of gap between our understanding and the Americans' understanding?
Well, it seems to me that Secretary Kerry, just like President Obama, are determined to persist in their ideology and policy, irrespective of reality. This has been going on for the last 6 years. Israel should turn more and more towards Congress, and not only because there is a new majority in the Senate, because most Democrats, just like most Republicans, understand the Israeli side, and therefore we should appeal first and foremost to the American constituents and then to American legislators to put an end to this farcical reality of American taxpayer funding hate education system run by Mahmoud Abbas, which indoctrinates and manufactures lines of terrorists in this part of the world.
Let's hope so. Thank you, Ambassador.